I know I don't want to be spit on. I know you spit on me by a natural reaction. I might swing off on you. And that's what happened. So I'm not defending him, because this is where the arguments of society came about. It was the fact that the men were literally saying the same thing I was saying. And the women were like, oh, no, that's domestic violence. I wouldn't say. Bitch, how much do you make an hour? How much does he make an hour? Which way is the woman you think she going to go? First of all, she love him. Second, this ain't the first time they've had a fight. It's just the first time y'all seen a fight. And because he's a public figure, automatically, let's give him the death penalty. Let's kick him out the league. Let's make him an example. Okay? You fucking up his money. You fucking up his livelihood. You fucking up his family. Why? Because the public wants to jump on the situation and voice their opinion and say, this is what needs to be done. But this is the same public who we forgot not even a month ago. There's about 256 little kids missing in Africa.
Right.
And then a month before then, we were all screaming justice for Ferguson. And then before then, we were screaming something else. So I truly believe it only happened because the media made it be more than what it was. And the NFL, who's a brand, who has an image that they have to protect, did what they had to do, knowing after a while it'll blow over, we put them back into business. Because my thing is this. Y'all niggas threw Vic in jail and chastise them for making two dogs fight. Okay? Y'all gonna ban this nigga from the league completely because him and his wife had that in a video that most of y'all would not have ever known about if society wasn't so greedy and somebody wants to leak the tape to try to make some money.
And here's what makes it lose its credibility is when, like you said, the fight, by the time we saw the video, it had already occurred months prior to.
Right.
The fact that after that happened and his wife still got up there and stood by his side, it's like, at the end of the day, like you said, I do not, and I want all the listeners out there to hear this, I do not ever condone a man putting his hands on a woman. I don't condone a woman putting her hands on a man because it does happen. Domestic violence is wrong, okay? But in the same breath, that's like if I date a guy, he's knocking me off all upside my head, and I choose to stay with him because I, whatever the case, whether it's his lifestyle, maybe she's really still in love, at the end of the day, how can I be taken serious when I'm still sticking by his side, defending him after he knocked my ass out?
Right, and that's the thing. At this point in time, even if domestic violence was occurring, we as people tend to always forget the obvious details that be in our face because we want to always find underlining stuff. It happened before they got married, okay? Meaning that when she came to and she realized what happened, she could have said, you know what, fuck you, I'm out of here.
Right.
No, she had 2 weeks to completely think about what happened before she said, I do. Nobody would have been mad at her if she walked away. Matter of fact, she could have even taken him to court, okay? Because he put his hands on her and would have walked off with a multi-million-dollar deal, which would have had her set for life. So at the end of the day, even though the, oh, she married him for the money, no, that would have went out the door. Because there would have been a legal team quick as hell to jump on that and say, ooh, he beat you. He put his hands on you. Let's go get paid because we all going to get paid. No, it didn't go that route. She decided to say, I am going to marry him because I love him. We were both at the wrong. It is in God's hand. We'll take care of that. Number two, okay? Remember, when the news broke, it wasn't him who stepped up in the public and was like, bro, why y'all blasting me? No, she said, will you please leave this situation alone because it is affecting our family? We do not want to relive a moment that we have already relived and put in our past. At that moment in time, the so-called victim told y'all to shut the fuck up. And that's what we should have done. Okay? We did not. At the end of the day, she basically said, shut the fuck up. is none of y'all business. We passed that. Go handle some important shit. Okay? And I'm done on that. I want to get on Mel B ass in a minute, though. But what we're going to do is we're going to get to something we normally do at the top of the hour. We are going to do the artist spotlight. Or did you tell you that already? See, I was driving.
No, we haven't gotten to that yet. We did not do that.
All right. Tasha, go ahead and introduce the artist spotlight this week, because this is your show.
Yes, yes. This artist spotlight, this lady follows me on Twitter. Yes, Twitter word. And I came across her music, and I was like, okay, I'm kind of feeling it. This artist, some of you may know her, others may not. Her name is Kiana. And the name of this song is called The Habit, and it's featuring Rocco. So check this out, and we'll be right back.
Twin set up.
Yeah,
it's me. It's done.
Shout out Kiana.
Paris, what up?
Brilliant.
SL, what's up?
I can't free myself.
Taste. where the topic we talked about earlier is when your ex expects you to wait on them.
Yeah, fuck shit.
I'm sick of that, okay? Because I didn't get a chance to speak on this earlier because, once again, I was driving, but I heard you ladies talking on that. First of all, Tasha, was that the light-skinned dude doing that?
No, I don't think, no, this one, I don't think you ever knew about him. He is light-skinned.
Damn, I knew he was a light-skinned nigga. Could they do that
shit? But I don't think I ever really talked to you too much about him, because it wasn't like a bad breakup. It was like just bad timing, pretty much, and him talking about some, you know, all these things going on in my life. I can't really give you what you need. That was 3 years ago. 3 years later, he's still giving me the same speech. And mind you, I was not even checking for him like that, you know, around this time. He hit me up out the blue with the "I still love you" shit. So it just threw me completely off when he did that. And then, of course, when he came back with the same speech, I got a little irritated, like, okay, what was the whole point? You know, were you just saying that to get some ass? You know, because sometimes that happens.
And that's usually what it is. If an ex can't move on, okay, if they keep coming back, it's usually they notice the change that's happened to you since being with them, that caused them to want to try that again. So, for an example, women are notorious for doing this too. Okay, men do it more because at the end of the day, men are scared to do one of the most simplest things that they are not aware you can do with ease. Okay, and that's basically tell the truth. There's a lot of women out here, if you just flat out, fellas, come out and say, "Hey, baby, right now my life is kind of hectic. I work a job. I actually, you know, take care of my kids. I'm trying to go back to school. I got this small little side business I'm working on. I can't really commit to a full-blown relationship. Don't get me wrong. There's nobody else on the side, okay? I just can't be the kind of relationship I feel that you deserve to be. But if you ever want to fuck, I'm always there to call." But fellas, don't say it like that, because right away the woman is going to be offended. And in most cases, if you're not sexy, she gonna say no. I'm just gonna be honest with you. But be subtle with it, be honest with her, be open with her. Just say, "Hey, I have human needs, and I would rather me to be with somebody that I've already been with once before than to go
right
out here and deal with somebody else's." And believe it or not, guys, women love to recycle dick. They would rather recycle dick, meaning deal with someone they've already dealt with, who knows their body, who knows they want, they know what you're working with, they know what you can do, so they'll give you another chance than to go out here and go through the whole process of trying to find somebody new, and this nigga turns out to be a dick, an asshole, or a complete liar, when if you
right
be a friend saying, "Baby, I just want someone to fuck every now and then, and I would rather it be somebody that I've already been with, because I'm not going to lie to you, your sex is great. So I can't let go." Women sometimes be like, "Well, you know, I'm not on that," but give it about 48 hours and you'll get a phone call saying,
like,
you never know.
You never know. That's the thing.
The worst
thing
you can do is lie, but keep it real.
Yeah, thank you for putting that out there and coming from a male's perspective, because I can't tell you how many times, like, you know me, I'll post a question on Facebook in a minute to get people's responses to it. And I can't tell you how many times guys be like, "Well, you women can't handle the truth. That's why a lot of us men don't keep it real with you." You know, you're actually hurting yourself more by not being 100 upfront with us with what you want. You don't know. We could be on the same page. But how would you know
exactly
if you're lying and beating around the bush? So it's like you said, if he would have came to me out and been like, "You know what, Tasha, you know, I can't give you what I feel you deserve. You know, I'm not ready for that right now, but I would like to, you know, take it there with you, be intimate with you still, you know, because it's familiar territory." But no, he never came out and would say that, even
right
though I already knew that was the answer. I was waiting on him to tell me that, but since he did not, he got completely cut off from it.
Exactly, you fucked up, bro, because the shit I hear when they talk, bro, you fucked up, like, for real, you really did.
Don't listen, you are privy to so much information.
Yes, you are.
And,
been clean.
But you gotta understand,